It's just amazing the journey that this wood has been on. To think that it started to grow 1,000 years ago. It was cut down, it was floated down a river, it was installed in the roof of this church. And then the great tragedy came in 1945 when the roof was bombed and this wood ended up in rubble. And it could have been used as firewood, but it got saved. And all these years later, decades later, 70 years, so more than half a century later, it ended up with Eddie Bloeschinger and it became this guitar. Remind me again of how you even discovered this wood.
Well, it was on a radio show.
Okay.
In Munich, on one of the radio stations, and they were talking about this special wood, which were made, where violins were made out of it. It was a very nice documentary, and I had to find the guy. I was really excited. Gerald Fuchs' father was a wood dealer and violin maker from east side of Germany, and he went through Munich. Everything was devastated, everything was kaput, and he saw all these beams in the sacristy of the dome. So he got a hold of the priest and he could buy it. The father already died, and the son is also in his 70s now. And I contacted him and he was overwhelmed because his mission was to convince all the violin makers that this really ancient wood must have such a history and such a value to make great instruments out of it. They carbureted the wood. Gerald Fuchs did it on an institute, and it did say that I think the plant grew around 1100. And then it was in the Alps near the river Isar where they drifted the wood around 1460 on the river Isar down to Munich, where it became later on the roof of the church, which was completed. I think they started building it around 1460 and completed the church around 1490. And I thought it's very interesting. And I got a hold of Mr. Gerald Fuchs. I met him and I was able to buy a few beams. What he really was great for him was when he heard a real string quartet made of the instruments of the wood that his father saved. So far, he told me it's known that there are 43 violins, 3 celli, and 3 violas. So when I finished the first one, I went with my son to visit him, and he was almost in tears and was very, very happy. How emotionally we got for him to fulfill the mission of the father. The materials in all my guitars I'm making are always very special to me. Guitar making in general requires always the best materials you can get, but in this case it was really something extraordinary, something really special for me with such a history, and that was enormous fun for me to make the guitar.